Hello students, today's class is on units of measurement of solutes in solution. Introduction. A solution may be defined as a mixture of two or more non-reacting substances whose composition can be varied within certain limits. A mixture may be homogeneous or heterogeneous. A true solution or homogeneous mixture is a single phase system whose constituents cannot be separated from each other by physical methods like filtration, centrifugation, etc. The different constituents present in a true solution lose their physical properties. A heterogeneous mixture, on the other hand, can be separated easily by physical methods. A heterogeneous mixture is also called a colloidal or suspension. A solution may contain two or more constituents. A solution of two substances is called a binary solution. A substance which is dissolved in another substance is called solute, and another substance which dissolves the solute is called as solvent. In case of binary solution, the component or constituent present in smaller proportion or amount is called solute, and the one present in excess or larger amount is called solvent. The relative amount of solute and solvent present in a solution can be expressed in a number of ways, but here we focus on molarity, molality and normality. Let's see the types of solution. A solution may contain two or more components. A solution which has two components is called binary solution, for example normal saline. On the other hand, a solution with three components is called ternary solution, for example a solution of sodium chloride and potassium chloride in water. Similarly, even more than three components may be present. In case of binary solution, components or constituent present in smaller proportion or amount is called solute, and the one present in excess or larger amount is called solvent. In the aqueous solution of sugar, sugar is solute and water is solvent. The solution may be classified on the basis of solubility. The extent to which a solute dissolves in a solvent to form a saturated solution is a measure of solubility. Solution containing less amount of solute than the saturated solution at a given temperature is called unsaturated solution. And a solution containing excess amount of solute than the saturated solution at a given temperature is called supersaturated solution. A solution holding quite small amount of solute than the solvent is called a dilute solution. A mixture of two or more solvents which has definite composition and boiling point is called azeotropic mixture. For example, sulfuric acid 98.3% and water, which boils at 333 degrees Celsius. Depending upon the nature of the component acting as solvent, solution can be further divided into three types as solid, liquid and gaseous solutions. The liquid solution, in which liquid acts as a solvent while liquid, solid or gas acts as solute, are the most common type of solution. Now let's come to molarity. Although there are several ways in which the concentration of a solution can be quantified, molarity is one of the most basic and widely used. The molarity of a solution may be defined as the number of gram moles per liter of solution at a given temperature. Units of molarity is gram mole per liter or moles per liter. For example, if we want to prepare 1 molar sodium hydroxide solution in water, then we have molarity M is equal to gram moles of the solute divided by liters of solution. But 1 mole of sodium hydroxide is 40 gram of sodium hydroxide. So in order to prepare 1 molar sodium hydroxide solution, we must dissolve 40 gram of sodium hydroxide in 1 liter of water. More generally, the molarity of a solution is expressed as moles per liter or as millimoles per milliliter. As the volume of solution changes with the temperature, molarity of a solution changes with temperature. By using the solvent's mass in place of the solution's volume, the resulting concentration becomes independent of temperature. The goal of most basic molarity problems shall be to get the moles from grams by dividing the molecular weight and then dividing by the total number of liters, or by given the molarity, find the number of grams of the solution by multiplying the volume, then molecular weight. Molarity might give you the density of the solution, from which you can obtain the mass by multiplying the density by the volume. The molarity of the resulting solution of two solutions can also be calculated by using the formula M1V1 plus M2V2 is equal to M3 whole V1 plus V2, where M1 is equal to molarity of solution 1, V1 is equal to volume of solution 1, M2 is equal to molarity of solution 2, V2 is equal to volume of solution 2, M3 is equal to molarity of solution 3, and V3 is equal to volume of solution 3. Now let's come to molality. The molality of a solution is defined as the number of moles of solute per kilogram of the solvent, that is mole per kg. Mathematically, molality small m is equal to number of moles of solute divided by kg of solvent. Units of molality is gram moles per kg or moles per kg. For example, to make 1 molar aqueous water solution of sodium chloride, measure out 1 kilogram of water and add 1 mole of the solute, that is NaCl, to it. The atomic weight of sodium is 22.98 and the atomic weight of chlorine is 35.45. Therefore, the molecular weight for NaCl is 58.43 gram. So, 58.43 gram of NaCl could be dissolved in 1 kg of water for preparation of 1 molar solution of NaCl. In molality, the mass of the solvent is taken into account. Mass of the solvent does not change with the temperature, so molality is not temperature dependent. The molality is convenient in physicochemical measurements of the colligative properties of substances, such as freezing point depression, vapor pressure lowering, and osmotic pressure. It is because colligative properties depend solely on the number of solute particles present in the solution per mole of solvent. The molality of one solute in a solution is independent of the presence or absence of other solute. Now coming to normality. Normality of a solution may be defined as the number of gram equivalents of the solute dissolved per liter of the solution. Mathematically, normality N is equal to gram equivalents of the solute divided by volume of solution in liter. Units of normality is gram equivalents per liter. For example, let us make 1 liter of 1 normal H2SO4 solution from 97% pure sulfuric acid. To determine how many grams of sulfuric acid we need, we will first need to calculate the equivalent mass of H2SO4. This is the gram molecular weight divided by the number of acid hydrogens in the compound. So it is 98 divided by 2, which is equal to 49. Then we can calculate the amount of grams of H2SO4 that are needed. The formula to calculate this is grams of compound needed is equal to desired normality into equivalent mass into volumes in liter desired. Substituting the above numbers into the equation, we get grams of compound needed is equal to 1 normal into 49 into 1, which is equal to 49 gram. A 1 normal solution requires 49 gram of a pure sulfuric acid powder diluted to 1 liter of water. but the acid is a liquid and it is not 100% pure active sulfuric acid. So we will need to calculate what volume of the concentrated acid contains 49 gram of sulfuric acid. This problem can be overcome by using the formula: volume of concentrated acid needed is equal to grams of acid needed divided by percent concentration into specific gravity. Substituting the values in the equation, we get volume of concentrated acid needed is equal to 49 divided by 0.97 into 1.84, which is equal to 27.45 ml. So, if we take 27.4 ml of concentrated sulfuric acid and diluted it to 1 liter, we would have a 1 normal H2SO4 solution. As the volume of the solution changes with temperature, normality of a solution changes with temperature. A 1 normal solution contains 1 gram equivalent per liter. An equivalent represents the mass of material providing Avogadro's number of reacting units. A reacting unit is a proton or an electron. The number of equivalents is given by the number of moles multiplied by the number of reacting units per molecule or atom. Equivalence EQ is equal to mole into the number of reacting units per molecule. Milliequivalence MEQ is equal to millimole into number of reacting units per molecule, where mole is equal to number of moles, millimole is equal to number of millimoles. Now coming to equivalent weight. The equivalent weight is that weight of a substance in grams that will furnish 1 mole of reacting units. Equivalent weight is equal to the formula weight divided by the number of reacting units. Equivalent mass of acid is equal to molar mass of acid divided by number of replaceable hydrogen ion present. Thus, for HCl, the equivalent weight is equal to the formula weight. Equivalent weight of HCl is equal to the formula weight of HCl divided by 1, which is the equivalence per mole. In case of H2SO4, it takes only 1/2 the number of molecules to furnish 1 mole of H+, and so the equivalent weight is 1/2 the formula weight. Equivalent weight of H2SO4 is equal to formula weight of H2SO4 divided by 2, which is the equivalence per mole. Similarly, the equivalent mass of base, salt, element and ion can be calculated using the following formulas. Equivalent mass of base is equal to molar mass of base divided by the number of replaceable OH- ions present. Equivalent mass of salt is equal to molar mass of salt divided by total positive charge on cation. Equivalent mass of element is equal to atomic mass of element divided by valency of element. Equivalent mass of ion is equal to formula mass of ion divided by charge on ion. There are three common areas where normality is used as a measure of reactive species in solution. Number one, in acid-base chemistry, normality is used to express the concentration of hydronium ions or hydroxide ions in a solution. Here, 1 by equivalence factor is an integer value. Each solute can produce one or more equivalents of reacting species when dissolved. Number 2, in redox reactions, the equivalence factor describes the number of electrons that an oxidizing or reducing agent can accept or donate. Here, 1 by equivalence factor can have a fractional, non-integer value. Number 3, in precipitation reactions, the equivalence factor measures the number of ions which will precipitate in a given reaction. Here, 1 by equivalence factor is an integer value. Now coming to the relation between molarity and normality. Strength of solution gram per liter is equal to molarity into molar mass of solute, or strength of solution gram per liter is equal to normality into equivalent mass of solute. That is, molarity into molar mass of solute is equal to normality into equivalent mass of solute. Normality divided by molarity is equal to molar mass of solute divided by equivalent mass of solute is equal to N. So normality is equal to molarity into N, where N is equal to molecular mass divided by equivalent mass. Now coming to conclusion. The study of solutions is very important because many interesting and useful chemical and biological processes occur in liquid solutions. Preparation and handling solutions are essential part of experimental biochemistry. Molarity is based on the volume of solutions containing the solute. Since density is a temperature dependent property, a solution's volume and thus the molar concentration changes with temperature. By using the solvent's mass in place of the solution's volume, the resulting concentration becomes independent of temperature. Although there are several ways in which concentration of a solution can be quantified, molarity is one of the most basic and widely used. The molar unit is not used nearly as frequently as the molar unit and is used in thermodynamic calculations, where a temperature independent unit of concentration is needed. The term molality and molarity should not be confused. While expressing the molality, it is represented as a small m, whereas molarity is represented by an uppercase M. The concentration of a solution could also be expressed in terms of normality. Since normality simplifies the calculations required for chemical concentration, it is widely used in analytical chemistry. Any quantitative study of solutions requires that we know the amount of solute dissolved in the solvent or concentration of the solution. Thank you.